Roll number one. Roll number one. Good morning, students. Roll number one.
Good morning, ma'am.
Roll number one, absent. Roll number two.
Present, ma'am.
Three.
Present, ma'am.
Four.
Present, ma'am.
Five.
Present, ma'am.
Six.
Present, ma'am.
Seven.
Present, ma'am.
Eight.
Present, ma'am.
Nine.
Present, ma'am.
Ten.
Present, ma'am.
11. 11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14. 14. Roll number 14. 15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present, ma'am.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21. 21. 22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28.
Present, ma'am.
29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32. Roll number 32. 33
present ma'am
34
present ma'am
35
present ma'am
36
present ma'am
37
present ma'am
38
present ma'am
32 present acha 33 roll number 33 roll number 33 present or absent
present ma'am
35
ma'am 33 present
okay 35 35 roll number 35
present ma'am
36
present ma'am
37
present ma'am
38
present ma'am
39 40
present ma'am
41
yes ma'am
42
yes ma'am
43
present ma'am
44
yes ma'am
45 roll number 45 who is roll number 45
ma'am roll number 1 present
roll number 14 roll number 21 roll number 21 roll number 39 and roll number 45 roll number 45 absent so four roll numbers are absent it is showing 43 so how it could be four roll number 14 absent roll number 21 absent roll number 39 absent and roll number 45 absent so four students are absent what is the case show up scene 21 so roll number 14 39 and roll number 45 three students are absent roll number 45 you are absent today Is the sharing screen visible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Now this is double refraction. After this law of Malus I discussed. Now isotropic and anisotropic medium. An isotropic medium that is glass slab contains a periodic regular and identical arrangement of atoms in all directions so atoms are regular periodic, regular and identical in all directions. So when a light ray passes through this medium, it will move with same velocity in all direction. And this medium refracts only one single ray. Then anisotropic medium, there are many crystalline substances where the interatomic distances along different directions are different. The atoms are arranged in an irregular manner. So if a light ray passes through this medium, it will not maintain a constant velocity in all directions. Thus, the velocity of light through this medium is not constant in all directions due to different optical properties. This type of medium is known as anisotropic medium. So more than one refracted ray could be obtained from this anisotropic medium. So first one is isotropic medium. So what is isotropic medium? See, so these are the atoms. So this arrangement of atoms, these are periodic. Periodic and regular. Periodic and regular. And when like an interatomic distance fixed, that is this distance. What is fixed? So the interatomic distance fixed for isotropic medium and the atoms are arranged periodically and regularly. When light passes through this isotropic medium, then velocity of light remains same throughout the medium. So as the atoms are arranged periodically and regularly and the interatomic distance is fixed, so when light passes through this medium, then the velocity of light unchanged throughout this medium. This is isotropic medium. Next, coming to anisotropic medium, say if this is the distance, then this is the distance. Say this is the distance of the atoms. So you can see this distance and this distance, they are not same. So this is, say, anisotropic medium. This is anisotropic medium. So the interatomic distance, it varies and the atoms are not arranged regularly and periodically. So this is the example of, this is the figure of anisotropic medium. When light travels through this medium, the velocity of light is not fixed throughout the medium. It varies in different directions. And another difference is that for anisotropic medium, we can get more than one refracted ray. But for isotropic medium, this is the isotropic medium where we will get only one type of refracted ray. So only one type of refracted ray is possible in isotropic medium. But in anisotropic medium, we can get more than one refracted rays. So these are the difference between the isotropic medium and anisotropic medium. Okay. Kunal Kesh. Hello. Kunal Kesh, are you here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So say the difference between the isotropic medium and anisotropic medium, what I have just discussed. Tell me. Kunal, tell me the difference between the isotropic medium and anisotropic medium. What happened? So you are not listening. I will note down the names in this way. Okay. And whenever I will give internal marks, you will get less marks because you are not attentive in my class. Tell me something. So why you are muted? Kunal? So I'm noting down your name that I have explained in detail these two mediums and you have not given answer. So two restrictions have given for you all the students. Listen, first one, you have to be present in my class, first thing. And last thing is what? You have to listen. I can't contact directly to all the students here because this is online class, this is not offline. But while I will take the class, I can ask the questions and I can judge that you are listening or not. Kunal, what happened? When I was saying that Kunal case, then you were, yes ma'am, then you are muted.
Ma'am, actually I'm traveling. You are traveling in the class time.
Where are you going?
Ma'am, going home.
Going home?
Yes, ma'am. I am out of station.
Out of station?
And I am returning.
What? Listen, just listen. I will take drastic action after that. If you have picnic, you can go on Saturday and Sunday and holidays. When classes are going on, why are you outside? Why are you outside? You don't know you have class from 10? When you will get less marks in internal marks, then you will get the result. Whatever you are doing, you all will get the result. So this is about Kunal Kesh. So I'm noting down your roll number and name. Abhishek Chaudhary.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the difference.
Ma'am, in isotropic, the distance between them is fixed.
Between them means? Between them means, ma'am, you and your friend.
The atom, ma'am.
Then?
Is fixed. And
distance
it
between
is
the atoms, that means what is the name? Distance between the atoms, what is the name? Interatomic distance. I said, but you are not saying that thing. Then?
And ma'am, it is periodic.
Then?
And ma'am. Ma'am, it is regular.
Mm.
And ma'am, in anisotropic, the distance between them is not fixed. They are irregular and they are.
And when and light travels through this medium, then what happens?
Ma'am, in isotropic, the refracted ray is only one, and anisotropic medium, their refracted rays are more, ma'am, due to their irregular shapes.
So what about the velocity of light throughout along these mediums?
Ma'am, in isotropic medium, the velocity will remain constant. But in an isotropic medium, the velocity will vary.
In anisotropic medium, in isotropic, yes, it is constant. In anisotropic,
it will vary.
It will vary. So students, just I am giving negative point to Kunal Kesh and positive point to Abhishek Chaudhary. Now in this way, I will make list every day. And whenever I will give the internal marks, you will get the effect of this. And also, if you are absent in my class, you will also get the effect in the internal marks. And you know totally the last, exam, the last semester exam was totally internal and no offline exam was there. So you can think what will be your condition later. In physics, you have 200 marks. So what will be your condition, you can judge. Including practical total you have. What happened, Shobhan Nayak?
Ma'am, doctor dikhane gaye the.
Doctor dikhane gaye the, kya hua tha?
Ma'am, tabiyat thik nahi hai, isliye.
किसका तुम्हारा
है? यस मैम.
क्या हुआ
मैम? पैर में लग गई है.
कैसे एक्सीडेंट हुआ क्या?
गिर गए थे सीढ़ी से.
सीढ़ी से गिर गए? टूटा फूटा गई तो
नहीं सर? नहीं मैम.
ओके सो आई सो वन व्हाट इज योर रोल नंबर
मैम? 45.
ओके सो आई want to warn all the students, if you have any work, go on Saturday and Sunday or in holidays. Don't go whenever you have class. If you are missing the class, all the roll numbers I am noting down were not present in my class, and you will get the effect, total effect in your result. So you are intelligent enough, all of you. So tell your also parents that you are not attending the classes or you are not following what I am saying, you are not listening, so you will get poor marks in physics. Beforehand, just give the information to your parents. Understand, all of you. So Kunal, be very, very cautious from my next class. You are already in the negative side. And the remaining students, you also may be in the same side. So be very, very cautious about that. Is the sharing screen is visible? SAD screen, is it visible? I have changed my internet connection. So I want to ask the students.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Now double refraction. So double refraction, that is, occurs in anisotropic medium. So for that reason, I explained what is isotropic and anisotropic medium. This is very important, note down. When an unpolarized light is incident on an anisotropic crystal, so this is one crystal, this is say calcite crystal, this is the figure of calcite crystal, So calcite crystal, the light, this light is unpolarized. This light is unpolarized. Incident light, it is passing through the calcite crystal. Then it is divided into portions. This is the incident light. And here, after passing through the crystal, you are getting two types of rays. One is E ray and another is O ray. So two refracted. So these are the two refracted rays. The unpolarized light, it is divided in two parts. And one first name is E ray and the second name is O ray. So when unpolarized light is incident on an anisotropic crystal, namely calcite, the incident light is split up into two refracted plane polarized light. E ray means extraordinary ray and O ray means ordinary ray. So what I said about the anisotropic medium, we can get more than one refracted rays. So when unpolarized light passes through this type of anisotropic medium, here we are getting two types of rays. One name is E ray and another name is O ray. Now, tell me the significance of this arrow sign and dot sign. E ray for E ray, this is shown by electric field vectors. That is the shown by arrow. What is the significance of this? And what is the dot sign? What is the arrow sign and what is the dot sign? Tell me. Anyone can tell me what is dot sign and what is arrow sign?
Ma'am, dot equal to polarized, arrow equal to not polarized.
Dot also polarized, arrow also polarized. No dot and arrow combination. So this is also polarized, this is also polarized. So dot by dot sign, what you represent?
What is perpendicular to the plane of paper?
Yes, vibration of the light is perpendicular to the plane of paper and vibration of the light is along the plane of paper, parallel. Okay, this light. Now the next. So this is double refraction. So you are getting doubly refracted rays. Doubly refracted rays. When unpolarized light passes through any anisotropic medium, say calcite crystal, you are getting two types of refracted rays. One is E ray and another is O ray. And the vibration, direction of vibration, this is different. E ray is, it is shown by arrow sign. And for O ray, it is shown by dot sign. Now the next. Why it is called O ray and E ray? When an unpolarized light is incident on an anisotropic crystal, example calcite, it produces two refracted rays by double refraction process. Double refraction means what? Why the name is given? Because you are getting two types of refracted rays. You are getting two, that means double refracted rays. So it is double refraction. One of these rays, one of the two refracted rays, obeys the ordinary Snell's law of refraction and having vibration perpendicular to the principal section of the crystal. I told you that is in the plane of the paper. Now here we are taking the crystal, calcite crystal. So the principal section, so that section that is taken for the calcite crystal, the O ray has vibration perpendicular to that. And this ray is known as ordinary ray. And other refracted ray does not obey the ordinary Snell's law of refraction and having vibration along the principal section of the crystal. And this ray is known as extraordinary ray. So E ray. So this is the section, principal section of the crystal. This is the, say, the principal section of the crystal. Now O ray and E ray, how it is defined? If it is perpendicular, O ray has vibration perpendicular to the principal section of the crystal and E ray has vibration along the principal section of the crystal. And E ray, it does not obey the Snell's law, ordinary Snell's law. And so it is extraordinary light. And this is ordinary light because it is the, it obeys the Snell's law of refraction. So one of these two rays, so which ray obeys the Snell's law of refraction? This is ordinary ray. And which ray does not obey the Snell's law of refraction? This is extraordinary ray. And it has vibration along the principal section of the crystal. And so two types of rays you are getting in double refraction. One is ordinary ray and another one is extraordinary ray. Ordinary ray does not follow Snell's law of refraction, but ordinary ray follows the Snell's law of refraction, but extraordinary ray does not follow the Snell's law of refraction. Now the vibration of ordinary ray, it is perpendicular to the principal section of the crystal and it is known as O ray, and E ray has vibration along the principal section of the crystal. So this is, remember this one, whenever it is given double refraction, you have to remember this figure. Now I just read it on. I have given the note on your own. Huygens theory of double refraction. You will understand. Now coming to uniaxial and biaxial crystals. The crystals in which there exist only one such direction along which the velocity of the two refracted rays are same is known as the uniaxial crystal. Example is calcite and quartz. A doubly refracting crystal possessing one optic axis may be called uniaxial crystal. And the crystal in which there exist only two such directions, that is optic axis along which O ray and E ray travels along the velocity, same velocity, then it is the biaxial crystal. Say, just I'm drawing. Say, so what is optic axis? Optic axis, say this is the anisotropic medium. Say this is anisotropic medium. So this is, say this is the anisotropic medium. Now in anisotropic medium, how many you will get double refraction, is it? In anisotropic medium, hello, in anisotropic medium, is it possible to get double refraction? Yes or no?
Yes,
yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am. Yes ma'am.
Okay, so velocity, actually the velocity of O ray and E ray, they are different though. O ray and E ray, these are different rays, different refracted rays, they have different properties. And the velocity of O ray is, and the velocity of E ray, they are different. But if any crystal, say this is the direction, say I'm showing this is the, what is the direction? This is the direction through which light travels. There is no double refraction. What is the meaning of that? Only in this direction AB, say this is the crystal, anisotropic crystal. Now here, if the light travels along A to B, there is no double refraction. That means what? In this direction, the velocity of O ray and the velocity of A ray is same, is it? Double refraction means, double refraction means you will get two refracted rays. Double refraction means you will get two refracted rays, O ray and E ray. But say in a crystal, there is one particular direction through which if light travels, you will not get double refraction. Double refraction you will not get. That means only one type of refracted ray will get. That means in that case, the velocity of O ray and velocity of E ray is same. They have same properties, so you can't detect, and you are only getting one type of refracted rays. But if we choose this direction, if we choose this direction, say CD, you are getting double refraction. So here, say in this direction, VO is not VE. So only AB is the direction, only AB is the direction through which you are not getting double refraction. But if light travels in any direction, other than this, you are getting double refraction. So velocity of O ray and velocity of E ray is not same in all other direction except in this direction. Understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
And what is the definition of optic axis? Optic axis, actually it is not a particular axis. This is the direction. Optic axis is actually the direction through which if light travels, there is no double refraction. That means if light travels through this direction, you will not get any double refraction. So the velocity of O ray and E ray is same along the optic axis direction. So optic axis is not a particular axis. Actually, optic axis is a direction through which if light travels, there is no double refraction. So I have shown the AB is the direction through which there is no double refraction. So AB is the direction of which? Optic axis. AB is the direction of?
Optic axis.
Optic axis.
So along AB optic axis is there. Now all the lines parallel to AB is also the direction of optic axis. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All the lights traversing in this direction, also this is all the optic axis of the crystal. So optic axis is not a particular axis, but it is the direction through which if light travels, there is no double refraction, because in this direction, say for this VO equal to V, here VO equal to V. So if light travels through this, there is no double refraction. Only one type of refracted ray we get, because the velocity of O ray and velocity of E ray is same. So if in any crystal, that means if tum log koi bhi crystal lo, to us crystal mein ek particular direction aisa hoga jisme light travel kare to bhi double refraction nahi hoga. That means you will get only one type of refracted rays. But excepting this direction, if light travels through all the directions, then in all the directions you will get doubly refracting rays. So what is uniaxial crystal? If in any crystal there is only one optic axis, then it is called uniaxial crystal. And if you are getting any crystal where you are getting two optic axes, so that is called biaxial crystal. Two optic axes means two such directions through the crystal through which if light travels, there is no double refraction. So remember this one. This is very important. So I'm again drawing this one. So in the this is the direction of the optic axis. If light travels through this direction, there is no double refraction. So this is uniaxial, only one direction. So this straight line is only one. So from this to this direction, if light travels, then it is uniaxial crystal. So light travels, say, through this direction, it is what? Uniaxial crystal. That means one optic axis. What is the optic axis? Optic axis is along this direction, AB. Now there, the velocity of VO equal to V. The velocity of O ray and velocity of E ray is same in this direction. And say, I am just drawing another one. Say, light is traversing in this direction and in this direction. Into these two directions, velocity of O ray equal to velocity of E ray. VO equal to V. So this is two optic axis. So this is one optic axis and this is another optic axis. So through which VO is V, no doubly refracting ray you will get through this direction. If light travels in this direction, what will happen? In this direction, VO not equal to V, excepting AB and this CD. So here you are getting two optic axes, AB and CD. So all the rays parallel to AB, also the optic axis. So all the axes parallel to AB, also the optic axis of the crystal. And all the rays parallel to what? CD, also the optic axis of the crystal. So two directions are... So two optic axis means two directions inside the crystal through which if light travels, there is no double refraction. Clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is, take the example, the crystals in which there exists only one direction along which if the velocities of the two refracted rays are same, it is known as uniaxial crystal. Example, remember the example, calcite quartz, they are uniaxial crystal. So doubly refracting crystal possessing one optic axis may be called uniaxial crystal. Optic axis means that axis through which if light travels, there is no double refraction. And the crystals in which there exists only two such directions, known as two optic axis, O-ray and E-ray has same velocity. This is biaxial crystal. Aragonite, copper sulfate, these are all biaxial crystal. Another classification of crystals are there. That is positive crystal and negative crystal. Depending on the velocities of O-ray and E-ray inside the crystal may be positive and negative. So what is positive crystal? If the velocity of O-ray is greater than the velocity of E-ray inside the crystal, then the type of the crystal is positive crystal. So VO is greater than VE. So this is positive crystal. And if remember this one, the and you know mu equal to C by V, this formula you know, refractive index equal to C by V. The refractive index of E-ray. So a thing. So for positive crystal, what I said? What will be the velocity of O-ray?
Greater than E-ray.
VO is greater than VE, is it? Mm. So for O-ray, if I write mu O, then what I will write? C by VO? Mu O, refractive index of O-ray. What I will write? Mu O equal to C by VO? Okay. Now VO is greater than VE. So what will be mu O? Mu O is less, is it? Understand what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Mu is greater than VE. So if I write mu E, we can write mu E equal to C by V, or we can write mu O equal to C by VO. So now VO is greater than VE. So whenever I'm writing, so as the denominator is maximum here for VO. So mu O will be minimum. So mu O is less. And mu E is greater, so the refractive index of E-ray, that is mu E, will be greater than mu O for positive crystal. Remember this thing, may be given in MCQ. So mu O is greater than mu E for positive crystal. Remember, for positive crystal, PO is greater than P. So mu O is less than mu E, or you can write mu E is greater than mu O. Remember this example, quartz, iron oxide, these are the positive crystal. And the same way, the figures are shown in the optic axis. Negative crystal, this is the direction of the optic axis are shown. Just read the Huygens theory. I have given it. Actually, your syllabus is very, very, that is, it is a big syllabus. And through online, it is very difficult to cover. So something you have to prepare yourself, as I am doing also in whiteboard. So it is taking time. So you will read the Huygens principle, and it is the figure of positive and negative crystal. Now, what negative crystal, if the velocity of E-ray is greater than O-ray, the crystal, that is negative crystal, and you can see the same way that the refractive index of O-ray will be greater, that mu O will be greater than the E-ray. So mu O is greater than mu E here, just opposite. Calcite, tourmaline, these are the examples of negative crystal. So these are some examples, problems here. So calculate the velocity of the ordinary and extraordinary rays in calcite crystal in a plane perpendicular to the optic axis. The refractive indices of the calcite crystal for E-ray and O-ray, it is given as this. You know the formula, mu O equal to C by O. Here what is taken, what I was saying as VO and V, it is written as CO and C. No problem for this. Just write this, mu equal to C by V. Velocity, so mu O, according to this, it is written C by C0 and mu equal to C by CE. So you can calculate CE equal to what? C by mu E, and all the values are given. So from there, you can calculate what will be the refractive index. Refractive index are given. So calculate the velocities of the ordinary light and extraordinary light from this formula. So remember, mu equal to C by V, only this formula. Now, the axis of a polarizer, this is the problem. Do you know, when unpolarized passes through any polarizer, what will be the intensity of the polarized light? It is always half. Do you know this? I equal to I0 by 2? Do you know this? So, I equal to I0 by 2. If unpolarized light passes through any polarizer, so after passing through the polarizer, the intensity of the polarized light equal to I0 by 2. I have the calculation. I will give it in your, I can give it later in your group. So the axis of a polarizer and analyzer are oriented at 30 degrees to each other. Mm. when the unpolarized light of intensity I zero is incident on the polarizer, what will be the incident intensity of the transmitted light? So just I'm saying, just a minute. Now, what is the problem given? The axis of polarizer and analyzer. Say, this is one polarizer and this is analyzer. It is placed. Intensity of the unpolarized light. Here the light is what? Unpolarized light. And intensity is I zero given. And the angle between polarizer 1 and polarizer 2. What is the angle given? 30 degree. Angle is given 30 degree. What is the intensity of the transmitted light? What will be the intensity here? You have to calculate. Okay. So here it is I0. Here it is I0. And here it is I1, say the intensity. And here it is I2, different. You know, I1 and I2, two different intensities. Then what is the relation between I2 and I1? Tell me, yesterday I discussed. I2 equal to what? I1?
I1 cos square theta.
I2 equal to I1 cos square theta. And what is the relation between I1 and I0? The relation between I1 and I0, actually.
I1 equal to I0 by 2.
Okay. I1, this intensity always half. When first unpolarized light becomes polarized, the intensity is half. I0 by 2 here. This is polarized light, actually. This is polarized light. And this is also polarized light. So first, when it passes through, the intensity is half. So I1 equal to I0 by 2. So now, I2 equal to what? I1 cos square theta. So what I will write? I2 equal to what?
I0 by 2 cos square theta.
So you can find out. If you calculate, you will get 0.375, then I0. So this is the... Then this type of, say, the, this is the, here again, if another one is placed. Maybe you may have to calculate the intensity here, in this position. So what I2 you have now, and here it is, say, I3. Now, the angle between, the angle between this one and this one, you can calculate the angle between these two. And now the what will be the formula? I3 equal to what? I3 equal to I2?
I2 cos theta 1.
Say, and theta 1 is the angle between these two polarizers. Okay, but if it is P3, so angle between P2 and P3 is, if it is given, then you can calculate I3. I3 equal to I2 cos square theta 1. If the angle between them is what? Theta 1. So you can find out in this way. If four, five polarizer or Nicol prisms are placed in this way, so, you can calculate it. Understand? So, time is actually over.
Ma'am, college kab open hoga, koi notice hai?
Nahi hai. Tum logo ka notice to kuch nahi hai. Jab government order dega, tab hoga. College to khud open nahi ho sakta na. बंगाल में तो बंगाल क्या सभी जगह पे तो बंद है सब कुछ. इन आईटीज आईआईटीज में भी ऑनलाइन क्लास चल रहा है. तो कॉलेज कैसे ओपन होगा गवर्नमेंट का नोटिफिकेशन को छोड़ के? समझे?
मैं एक कॉलेज देखा था, मैं नोटिस दिया था 25 जनवरी ओपन हो गए. क्या नाम था मैम उस कॉलेज का? मैम देख के बोलते हैं आपको.
सुनो ना, हम क्या बोल रहे हैं, वेस्ट बंगाल में कहीं भी कोई भी, मानो ऐसा हुआ था लॉकडाउन में जब चल रहा था, बहुत सारा स्कूल ओपन किए थे, क्लास लिए थे, उसके अगेंस्ट स्टेप्स लिया गया था, जानते हो? गवर्नमेंट का नोटिफिकेशन को छोड़ के कोई भी क्लास ओपन नहीं कर सकता, ठीक है? तो वो जो कर रहा है अपने जिम्मेदारी पे कर रहा है, उसके ऊपर कुछ प्रॉब्लम आ गया तो उसके उसको उसे समझना होगा क्या होगा नहीं होगा.
तो हम यही बोलना चाहते हैं तुम्हें नोटिफिकेशन मिल जाएगा तुम लोगों को. हम लोगों को पता नहीं है अभी कब क्या ओपन होगा नहीं होगा कुछ भी पता नहीं है. ठीक है जब भी कुछ होगा नोटिस है सर ना. ओके तो वो पता नहीं है तो पता चल जाएगा. हम लोगों को कुछ भी पता नहीं है गवर्नमेंट जब नोटिफिकेशन करेगा तो तब होगा. कोई भी कॉलेज अपना रिस्क पे कोई क्लास ले रहा है कि ऑनलाइन को ऑफलाइन कर रहा है तो अपना रिस्क पे कर रहा है. ठीक है कुछ भी इधर उधर हुआ वहां से तो प्रॉब्लम उस कॉलेज का होगा. ओके सो द टाइम इज ओवर. आई एम एंडिंग माय लेक्चर एंड बी प्रेजेंट इन माय एवरी क्लास अदरवाइज यू ऑल विल बी इन प्रॉब्लम. सो डोंट बी सो बी इन सेफ साइड योरसेल्फ. यू आर इंटेलिजेंट एनफ बी ऑन सेफ साइड.